Penguin Random House Audio presents Wired to Eat. Turn off cravings, rewire your appetite for weight loss, and determine the foods that work for you by Robb Wolf. Read for you by Kaleo Griffith. The material in this audiobook is for informational purposes only and is not intended as a substitute for the advice and care of your physician. As with all new diet and nutrition regimens, the program described in this audiobook should be followed only after first consulting with your physician to make sure it is appropriate for your individual circumstances. The author and publisher expressly disclaim responsibility for any adverse effects that may result from the use or application of the information contained in this audiobook. Introduction. Beyond Paleo. I'm a 44-year-old father of two and husband to one. She is Italian and kind of territorial. I'm in pretty good shape and fiddle with Brazilian jiu-jitsu and old guy gymnastics. 20 years ago, I was a biochemist working in the areas of cancer and autoimmunity research. And I was sick. So sick, due to ulcerative colitis and a number of other niggling problems, that I was facing a bowel resection, statins, blood pressure medications, and antidepressants. That was the good part. The darker portion of the story went like this. I thought I was going to die, and the idea was pretty appealing, considering how much my life and health sucked. I was a mess. Through an interesting set of circumstances, which you'll hear about later in the audiobook, the idea of a paleo or ancestral diet made its way onto my radar, and out of abject desperation, I tried this seemingly wacky way of eating. This decision saved my life. All my health problems resolved in a matter of months. I shared this transformation with my doctors, including my gastroenterologist, rheumatologist, general practitioner, and therapist, all of whom said, "It's great that you're doing better, but it has nothing to do with your dietary changes." Some people in the medical and academic world play an interesting game. If you say to them, "I hit my hand with a hammer and it hurt," their response is, "Well, naturally." But if you tell these same people that changing your nutrition had a profound impact on your health, the response is, "Well, that's nice, but it's just anecdotal." There's a common saying in science land, "A million anecdotes do not one shred of evidence make." This is true, but if you see a million of the same anecdotes, perhaps it's time to apply some scientific rigor to the question, yes? Whether my experience of profound health improvement by modifying what I ate was scientific or quasi-mystical, it convinced me that working through the mainstream outlets was not where I wanted to spend my time. I'd been on a path to attend medical school, but the prospect of becoming like my medical providers and professors effectively euthanized my desire to be a doctor. I wondered how I could best help people with their health and fitness, and spending 8 years learning about disease and disease management seemed like a circuitous route at best. So, I made a serious career shift and opened a gym. Well, actually, two gyms. And they happened to be the first and fourth CrossFit affiliate gyms in the world. I incorporated the paleo diet philosophy and tenets into my business, which included education about sleep, nutrition, and smart movement. I combined these elements to create a supportive, challenging group health and exercise model that folks loved. Our clients achieved remarkable success, ranging from profound weight loss to dramatically improved health. Our results were so impressive that my little 4,000 square foot gym in Chico, California was picked as one of Men's Health magazine's top 30 gyms in America. Word got out that what we were doing was different than the standard approach to health and fitness, and people wanted to know how to do this for themselves, their patients, and clients. I started blogging so I could reach an audience outside our local community and spend a lot of time traveling, not just in the U.S., but also internationally, to speak in front of tens of thousands of people on this topic. The more people who tried something like a paleo diet, the more remarkable stories I heard. The concept seemed to be spreading faster than a venereal disease on a college campus. I started a podcast that climbed to the top of the iTunes charts and wrote my first book, The Paleo Solution, which became a New York Times bestseller. I was as surprised as anyone by this success. Soon enough, the just anecdotal reports on how this way of eating was changing lives, now in the millions, shifted to some interesting scientific studies. There might be something to this fad diet after all. Still, there were some problems brewing. Both academics and the media love to portray the paleo diet as some kind of historical reenactment, poking fun at the caveman motif, which became inseparable from the paleo diet idea. For many people, the whole caveman shtick was a non-starter. So, although many millions were benefiting from the information people like myself were sharing with the world, far more people would not give paleo eating more than a glance due to an emotional response to the idea. My goal has always been to help as many people as possible. So this marketing and image problem was a significant hurdle. Perhaps even more frustrating, however, was the tendency for folks who actually follow the paleo diet to turn the general concepts into quasi-religious doctrine. Folks newly converted to paleo tended to be quite dogmatic in the insistence that this was the one true way to eat. Often, these devotees had reversed serious health problems with this way of eating, so their enthusiasm was understandable. But not many people enjoy the company of or the message from someone who comes across as a holier-than-thou diet zealot. The reality is, some of these folks might have had success on a low-carb version of paleo and never considered that other people, and even they themselves, might benefit from a higher-carb version. A remarkable number of people are insulin-resistant for reasons I will detail later. If these people restore their blood sugar levels through a low-carb diet, better sleep, and exercise, thereby reversing that insulin resistance, they often find they can tolerate eating more carbs and still lose weight. In Wired to Eat, I'll explain why this is and detail the latest research surrounding this idea. With my new program, you will discover where you are in this story and learn the amounts and types of carbs you can eat while staying lean and healthy. And that's just the beginning. The ancestral health or paleo diet model I talked about in my first book is incredibly powerful, but these concepts are tools and starting points, not final destinations. As you'll soon learn, one size does not fit all, and that has never been more evident than now with the newest research on personalized nutrition. As you will discover in Wired to Eat, you now have the opportunity to go beyond general guidelines and find which foods, including which carbs, work best for you, regardless of your age, weight, or health status. And that's what makes the plan in this book so unique. By the end of your journey, you will understand the genetic and epigenetic factors that govern how you are wired to eat. But perhaps more important, you will finally have a plan customized to your body to help you lose weight, regain your health, and live the life you want to live. No more guessing which foods are right for you. In a little more than 30 days, your life and health could be radically transformed for the better as you heal your gut and refine your personal eating plan. Part 1. Know thyself. How you are wired to eat. Chapter 1. One size does not fit all. If I have learned anything over the years, it's that we all tend to benefit from general guidelines, but our individual needs may be profoundly different than those of our neighbor. This can create a bias that makes us think what worked for us or someone we know will work for everyone. So, although we'd like to keep things as simple as possible, when we gear things for an individual's needs, things can get complex in a hurry. Understanding how and why we need to change our eating and lifestyle to be healthy or lose weight can be relatively easy in practice. Hey, buddy, just do this. But if folks need convincing, if they need to understand the whys and the details, well, that takes some work. So, which is better, simplicity or complexity? Well, it depends. Both approaches have pitfalls. An overly simplistic view of the paleo diet led to a mindless process of asking, is this food paleo? Versus the more appropriate question, is this food a good option for me? On the other hand, if the details on how the diet works start to look like advanced chemistry, a typical reader would rather roll around naked in broken glass. I will aim to strike a balance between the two extremes, giving you sufficient information in a simple way.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.